Bro, don't you know isolation exercises do nothing? What are you on about? Science has shown adding isolation exercises to a compound exercise program does not produce more muscle growth. Wait, what? You sure this is the correct interpretation of the research? Let me check what House of Hypertrophy has to say. Are compound exercises that train two or more muscle groups, enough for maximizing muscle hypertrophy? And are isolation exercises that train one muscle group, just a waste of time? A couple of scientific papers have suggested this. Let us examine them. A 2015 Brazilian study by Gentil and colleagues compared lat pulldowns to barbell biceps curls for elbow flexor growth. The elbow flexors consisted of the biceps and brachialis muscles in this case. After 10 weeks of training, increases in elbow flexor thickness were similar between the lat pulldown and biceps curl training, suggesting an isolation exercise, the biceps curl, does not produce any more growth compared to a compound exercise, the lat pulldown. However, this study does not tell us if compared to only performing lat pulldowns, the combination of lat pulldowns and curls could enhance elbow flexor growth. Fortunately, another 2013 Brazilian study by Gentil and colleagues evaluated this. Group 1 trained the bench press and lat pulldown. Group 2 performed the bench press and lat pulldown with the addition of a biceps curl and triceps extension. Both groups performed 3 sets of 8 to 12 repetitions to failure on each exercise per session. This meant training volume was not equated between both groups. As group 2 performed 2 additional isolation exercises, they would have accumulated higher training volumes. Despite this, after 10 weeks of training, increases in elbow flexor thickness were similar between both groups, indicating adding biceps curls to lat pulldown training does not enhance elbow flexor growth versus only training lat pulldowns. Unfortunately, the researchers did not assess triceps growth in this study. In 2015, another Brazilian study by Franca and colleagues further supported these previous findings. Group 1 trained with the following training program, consisting of only compound exercises. Group 2 trained with all the same compound exercises, but performed 2 added isolation exercises per session. Both groups performed 3 sets of 10 to 15 reps for each exercise per session, again meaning group 2 would have accumulated higher training volumes. After 8 weeks of training, increases in arm circumference were statistically similar between both groups, suggesting yet again that additional isolation exercises provide no further muscle growth benefit. These 3 research papers, the ones just overviewed, were later included in a 2017 review study by Gentil and colleagues, in which it was stated, the addition of SJ exercises to an MJ exercise program does not seem to increase gains in muscle size and strength. SJ stands for single joint, which are isolation exercises, while MJ stands for multi-joint, which are compound exercises. Before moving on, it's worth noting that since 2017, 4 additional studies, all published by Barbalho and colleagues, further indicate that additional isolation exercises to a compound exercise program do not enhance muscle growth. However, it's recently been established much research by Barbalho and colleagues contains improbable and atypical data. The data in these studies cannot be trusted, perhaps because the data is illegitimate. Thus, I believe we cannot use these studies as additional evidence.
Hello there.
You're killing your gains.
So it's clear some researchers speculate compound exercises may indeed max hypertrophy. But as many of you are probably thinking, surely there exist limitations and shortcomings. Indeed, I believe there are, And many of these limitations were nicely discussed in a paper by Ribeiro and colleagues that was directly responding to the Gentle and colleagues review paper. Firstly, only growth of the elbow flexors and arms were measured, and only at a single region of these muscles, roughly the midpoint of the muscles. This begs the question, what about other regions of these muscles, and what about other muscle groups? Examining the question about other regions of the same muscle first, I believe there's sufficient evidence to believe regional hypertrophy exists. That is, an exercise for a muscle does not grow all regions of that muscle equally. Rather, it grows some regions more than others. For example, Kawakami and colleagues found after subjects trained overhead extensions for 16 weeks, the triceps mainly increased in cross-sectional area in the middle to slightly lower regions, but in the most upper and lower regions of the muscle, little growth was experienced. Likewise, Emma and colleagues found after leg extension training for 12 weeks, growth not only differed between the quadriceps heads, but within each of these muscle heads, growth differed between the upper and lower regions of them. This data might suggest that if we wanted to maximize growth across as many regions of a muscle as possible, using a range of exercises that biomechanically differ could work. The biomechanically different exercises, when compared to each other, may target different regions of the muscle more so than others, so collectively they maximize growth across the regions of a muscle. Isolation exercises would be necessary and pivotal in this. A 2021 Brazilian study by Costa and colleagues supports this. 22 men were allocated into a non-varied or varied group. Both groups trained 3 days per week for 8 weeks. The non-varied group did train with both compound and isolation exercises, but they performed the exact same exercises on the 3 training days per week. The varied group, on each of the 3 days per week, perform different compound and isolation exercises for their muscle groups. Before and after the study, the researchers measured the thickness of the upper, middle and lower regions of the rectus femoris, vastus lateralis, elbow flexors and triceps. In a couple of measured regions, increases were similar between both groups. However, in other measured regions, gains favored the varied group. Thus, the varied group experienced the most regional hypertrophy overall. As a result, this study suggests performing a couple of different exercises for a muscle group, specifically 3 different isolation and compound movements per week, promotes more growth across regions of a muscle. Moving forward, other muscle groups not examined in the 3 previously mentioned studies are likely minimally trained with compound exercises. The lateral deltoid abducts the shoulder joint. No compound exercise significantly involves this motion, so isolation exercises that do this, like lateral raises, are likely required to maximally grow the lateral deltoid. The calf muscles plantar flex the ankle, a motion that no compound exercise significantly involves. So plantar flexion exercises like seated and standing calf raises are likely needed to max calf hypertrophy. Compound exercises training the hamstrings primarily do so via hip extension movement. However, the hamstrings also flex the knee, and there's evidence different parts of the hamstrings may be recruited during either hip extension and knee flexion motions. Thus, knee flexion exercises, like leg curls, are probably needed to max regional hamstrings hypertrophy. Compound exercises that train the quadriceps seem to grow the vasti muscle heads very well, but not the rectus femoris. Leg extension and reverse Nordic curls significantly develop the rectus femoris, so one of these isolation exercises are likely necessary to optimally grow all quadriceps heads. As for the triceps, 2 studies indicate the bench press fairly develops the lateral and medial triceps heads, but minimally the long head. You see, the long head crosses both the shoulder and elbow joints, the lateral and medial heads only cross the elbow joint. and many compound exercises that train the triceps, like the bench press, push-up, and even dips, involve shoulder extension during the lowering phase of the exercise, a motion that shortens the long head and inhibits it from significantly producing force during the lifting phase. Isolation exercises such as skull crushers, overhead extensions, and rope pushdowns have all been shown to significantly develop the long head. Moreover, recall the Costa and colleagues study found training with a variety of triceps isolation exercises in a week resulted in growth across more regions of the triceps. It's clear substantial hypertrophy can be achieved with compound exercises only. Yet, the conclusion compound exercises are sufficient for muscle hypertrophy is likely incorrect. Many muscle groups and regions of a muscle group are likely not optimally trained with compound exercises. Hence, additional isolation exercises are necessary.